What's going on, community? Down here in the middle of nowhere a little bit. Got some health problems recently, so sorry about not being able to be as quite as active as I usually am. But man, been a pretty crazy week, right? Let's see. The first one, obviously we kind of had a big spike around some redemptions. Been a lot of communication there. I want to make sure that people understand what's really going on with the system. They are higher than we like, but there's not really bug issues. It's just the nature of the lag. Now, me and CC did drop a video on this. That's where I like to refer to people right off the bat. Go there, check it out, get an understanding of what's going on. Make sure we understand what's really happening, right? And then the big news. We have the man himself move around 200 plus million. We're seeing that that's being deposited in, you know, Aave and Maker, a few different places that's generating a really large yield. Now, a couple of really interesting things. One, I think it gives us a signal that we are in a place where whoever runs those wallets, who shall now be named, not be known, could be a duck, could be the African priest, who, no telling, right? They are, one, comfortable enough to move the funds around, and two, they're comfortable enough to put those funds somewhere that's generating yield. Now, this could be very, very bullish, as we've seen how this particular set of wallets tends to operate when it comes to being very, very bullish, buying multiple assets, or all the assets that most of us care quite a bit about. That's been really, really huge for the ecosystem. And we see this not only the direct result of the price action, but we also see that it gives a certain level of confidence as when it comes to certain support levels. So again, could we be more bullish on those things? You can't. Huge, right? So we see that. That's a big move. I think the other one is we just saw a tweet from him. This one right here. Next to your TV, right? You can see it. So when you see him call out PulseX, right? So he talks about depth of liquidity and order execution. Now, for those that don't really know, when you have more liquidity, bigger depth, every move impacts that less, right? So if you have $10 on each side, $1 is 10%. It moves it around a significant amount. If you have 10 million, who cares what it moves? So RH highlighted that because PulseX has a lot of depth, there's better order execution versus thinner books. Now, that is important. That is very, very true. What I would like to highlight is the guys over at Piteas. They have done a fantastic job when it comes to order execution, and Piteas is what's called a DEX aggregator. Now, what that means is it will spread your buy across all these liquidity pools to make sure that you get the access to all of that depth from one click. Now, it is an imperfect science, but it's still really important that you can see how you can have fantastic order execution. And again, order execution just means that when you buy or when you sell, you get what you pay for. This is important, right? We talk about this all the time. So this is one, important to see how market makers and how people will move capital around the system. And the other that's really important, those of us that are more users or smaller bag holders, when people use a DEX aggregator, it allows those of us that want to put up LP, the Tang Gang actually does a great job about this. Those guys are absolutely bizarre, crazy, absolute degen savages. But there are crazy degen savages. They do a great job discussing a lot of like V3 liquidity on things like 9mm. There's Fox. There's a lot of these different places you can put LP. Why, again, this is super advantage to use something like a DEX aggregator is if you're a smaller user and you're putting your bag anywhere, you can basically go chase the APR. And someone who uses Piteas or a DEX aggregator doesn't have to come find you. They don't have to click that button. Piteas will go through and route, call this aggregation. It will go through and use all these sources, come find your bags, give you volume fees, and allow you to collect high APRs. So that's really good. So again, I know what RH is saying. He's very bullish on PulseX, as the rest of us are. A lot of us hold big bags of it. Very, very, very bullish. But something like a DEX aggregator allows bigger participants to come into the system and allows those of us to go in and order execute very, very well. And again, with a DEX aggregator, it will move a portion of those fees through PulseX, usually no matter what, especially on the big stables, USDC, USDT, USDL, and also PLS. So when we're moving through these big coins, a DEX aggregator is a really, really big deal. So that's huge. That's a big deal. We're really excited to see that, to get to see this kind of bullishness move through the ecosystem. It's super, super fantastic news. Really couldn't be happier about any of those things. One thing I would also like to shout out is the MCR guys. They dropped Barista. We talked a little bit, I think on the last update, why that's such a big deal. One, it's another fantastic team who's done nothing but educate. They're stand-up guys. I'm a very, very big personal fan of them. But also they give LL some redundancy. If you ever have an issue with the front end, you can use the other front end. This is important. It's nice to have that decentralized application. We see this with things like Hex. The other is they have the Bean token. Coffee Bean, Barista, that's their theme. It's kind of a neat deal. Now, whatever Bean does, that's up to the MCR guys. But what's cool for all the loan holders is you can go through their front end, stake some of your loan, and now take advantage of that extra incentive token. So, of course, the loan chart, we all know where it's at. It's tough. It's wrecked. It is what it is. But the yield is fantastic, and we're seeing multiple things already built on top. Less than 90 days or around 90 days, and there's already a new incentive token that comes out to loan holders. That's not a small thing. When you have a big audience, when you have something that has product market fit, you're going to see things built on top. People want to use utility. We saw this with something fantastic like Hex. We see this with blockchains when it comes to PLS. So I'm bullish, guys. I'm super excited. People are moving weight around. We've got new things being built. We've got projects coming live. I couldn't be more excited. I realize it's been a little tough week with redemptions. We'll see how the loan chart moves. But again, guys, charts and liquidity come with usage. They come with community. They come with an audience. And we have those things in spades. So again, we're always going to have little hiccups. It's growing pains. It is what it is. But guys, we should all be bullish. We should all be pumped. I'm going to keep working on trying to be more around, guys. Believe me, it's not lost on me that I haven't been as active as I usually am. Trying to get healthy on this stuff. We're going to do a lot of damage. I'll talk to y'all soon. Be safe.